What we're going to say first is, for each non-metal has a base name. So fluorine is fluor, chlorine is chlor, bromine is brome, and iodine is iode. So those are the base names. Those base names are going to be positioned in each of these blanks here. That's what goes in each one of these blanks, the base name. Now we're going to say, based on the number of oxygens present, that's going to determine the name of our polyatomic ion. So we're going to say when we have one oxygen present, the prefix will be hypo. The beginning of the name will be hypo. Based on the halogen present, it could have any one of these four base names. The ending, the suffix, will be ite. So remember, the prefix, which is the beginning of the name, will be hypo, and the suffix, which is the end of the name, will be ite. Now, if we possess two oxygens, we drop the prefix hypo, but we keep the suffix ite. And depending on which halogen you have, you plug in that base name. When we finally move on to three oxygens, the ite that we have changes to eight. And then finally, when we get to four oxygens, we get a whole new prefix, per. We'll still use one of these base names depending on which halogen is present, and then the ending will stay eight. So just remember this pattern, and you'll be able to answer any of these questions.